And so Workforce Management would like to thank everybody for joining us today for our December Town Hall. It's going to be very holiday-ish, festive, so get ready to be merry and bright. Roe and myself will be your MCs. We are fortunate to serve on the Workforce Management team as the IT leadership representatives, and so we will get started with today's update. Uh-oh, I think I hit the wrong thing. Yep, thank you. Today we'll have an update, and then we'll have our holiday celebration. So first, I've welcomed everybody, and we have some new employees for the year. This is the fiscal year, so you can see those individuals on there. We'd like to welcome them to IT. Thank them for, and I forgot to turn that off. That's my new Christmas item. If you're here in the room, welcome, and if you are online, we also welcome you. We have several folks that had career achievements this year. It was, I got to remember the numbers because I don't think, 92 individuals from IT, and it represented 1,185 years of service. So great, great, great. These are our 5-year achievements. Congratulations. 10 years. We'll leave it for everybody to see. If you're in the room and want to stand up or wave.
Congratulations, Angela.
Thank you very much. You
drank the company Kool-Aid.
I did. Yes. And if you notice, Melissa Byrne and Margaret Johnson, I think, are on there as well. And so the VMO is 10 years old. 15, the list starts to get a little smaller. Congratulations to these folks, as well as 20. All of these folks were pretty much came for a virtual congratulations. You should have gotten a catalog, and you get some points to buy a gift. And they are starting to have this back in person again. So if you have a career achievement next year, here's our 25 folks. You will get to come in for that celebration. And 30, wow, we had six of those. And 35 years, Julie Brumfield. I think she started when she was 5. And we actually had a 55-year, Patricia Snapp. She was in our HIM, and her gift was she got to retire. So congratulations to Patricia for her 55 years of service in November. She celebrated that as well as she celebrated her retirement. And I think she said she started when she was 5. HIM also had a sad moment this year. Stacy Black, HIM auditor, passed away after a long illness. So we'll just take a moment and remember her. And now I'm having technical difficulties. There we go. I'm going to turn it over to Roe, who's going to give us an organization and leadership update.
I have to go forward.
Oh, yeah, you do need this. There you go. Sorry about that.
Thank you, Angela. First of all, I'd like to say is that I do recognize that Buddy and our junior elf are not here. So I'm really bummed out. I hope they're feeling better. I believe they got the polar flu. It's contagious. That being said, they pulled me out of the fourth string. So you're going to get the worst part right now. So what I wanted to talk a little bit about was about our IT leadership open positions. I know this is something that's on everybody's top of mind. It's like, what do you want for Christmas? Right? So for the CDIO position, I'm glad to say that, Craig and Brian have teleconference with about 8 candidates. It's whittled down to 3, and I believe in the month of January, they'll start doing the group interviews, and then we should be able to have that in place. And then with that, we would look towards that person to hire in the other 2 positions, which is the associate CIO for outreach and applications, as well as the CTO as well. Okay, one of the things I wanted to go back and kind of go through about is that Where do we exactly sit as part of the organization? So if you look at that, you'll see Dr. Capiluto, our president on top, and then you'll see our co-VPHAs, Dr. DiPaolo and Dr. Monday, and then direct reports underneath. You will see that Craig Collins, who's our CFO, we have a dotted line as healthcare IT, and we report directly into CIO. And it's really looking at it as a systems approach. So this really is about more about alignment. What does that mean from your day-to-day? I don't think it has much fundamental impact on that. But if you have any questions, you know, at the end, you'll be able to send those over, and we can kind of talk that through. Unfortunately, you're still stuck with us. So even Michael's grimacing at me through that picture. So you're welcome. Okay. And we are really, really lucky to have additional clinical leadership who are partnering us and ensuring that we're actually falling to true north, and that's Jessica Collins, our CNIO, who's really awesome, and Dr. Romil Chadha, our notorious CMIO. Really great to have them as well. And if you have any questions in terms of where do I get the updates or information, we definitely encourage you to look at the enterprise updates to the University of Kentucky Board of Trustees. I believe you can actually, it's on YouTube. I'm talking like my mom, it's on the YouTube. And then there's the, I'm telling you, like literally pick the worst person to do this, right? He's like, but my sweater is better.
Yes, it is.
Okay, and then health system updates, as you can see on Thursday, December 7th at noon. It's scheduled as well. And there are periodic updates on that. So those are great places for us to get information. So with that, our goals.
And I try to put the systems update every other Thursday. Occasionally they skip a Thursday on our calendars. So if you can attend that, it's live, it's in this room. And then they also do record that just like we do. And then there's a great email summary that comes out in the loop. So if you miss it, you can go back to the enterprise loop and get that summary, and they'll answer all that they kind of talked about. Their slides are on there, the video recordings on there, and then any of the questions that they answered during that session are also there. And so they did just meet as a board last week, maybe this week even, and so that just came out. So I added that if you're truly interested in that very high level, what's going on within the university and with healthcare. And with IT, we're going to talk about our goals. So we started out with these very high-level goals. I just put them in here mainly, so if you want to reference back to it, you'll be able to come back to the slide deck. And then we're going to go through each one of the goals and just kind of say, tell you a little bit about how you can impact and make sure that we meet that. So one of the first ones is building our culture, and we focused on DE&I, and we're really focused on interviewing and making sure that we have a diverse staff. And so to do that, we wanted to look at the interview panels and some of our job bias and the postings that we have. And so there'll be a lunch and learn for the managers coming up so that we can communicate how we're going to make sure that we do those six items and that we track those. And then you as a staff member, if you're asked to be on one of those interview committees or interview panels, we just hope that you will participate. So we are hiring again, look for some interviews coming forth. The second one fell in line with the enterprise on our value-based payment screening measures, and that has to do with a lot of our projects. So most of the projects that we're tracking are our priorities, our must-dos, and we just need to make sure we execute those. So you can see what those project numbers are, what those names are, and so those are really, if they get executed, we'll meet this goal. Investing in our people, we focused on our professional development plans. So goals have opened in Success Factors. If you haven't loaded yours, both the leader goals are out there, which are these goals, and they can be cascaded down from the library, as well as your MJRs if you're a staff member, and you can go in and put in your goals as well as your results so that you can remember those. I know if you're like me, I don't remember what happened in July when I'm doing that goal in June, and so if we document those, it's an easier way to to make sure we don't forget something. But there's also a professional development goal. And so we want to make sure that everybody is thinking about, where do I want to get to and how can I get there? And my manager is working with me to get there. So what can you do in this year's time span? So your long-term goal might be to, if you want to be in a certain position, or you want to move to different departments, or you want to do something. And so this is the opportunity for you to write that down and have that discussion with your manager. And so we'll be tracking just to make sure that everyone has documented that. And then we also want to make sure you get training. So make sure you put those training hours in ServiceNow so we can say, as a department, we had X number. We're continuing with our continuous service improvement. We have a great team that volunteers to work that process and track those. And so we have a bunch that we need to get done, 70, along with 15 that have qualitative review, which means they had great metrics and really saw an impact in some area. And so the CSI committee will be doing a lunch and learn in January on their process, how to submit those CSIs, how to follow up on them, how to close them out, as well as they've got Deb Graham on schedule to come and tell us how the enterprise tracks and the process that they use for doing continuous service improvement, so a training opportunity. We're continuing to measure our SLAs. We started that last year, and we were about 91%, and so we're trying to improve that with this year's metrics. So when you get those incidents in, both acknowledging those as well as closing those out are a piece of that measurement. And I think this is the, nope, we've got two more slides. Providing options for patients to use technology. That's really all about my chart. So you can see we pulled out five of the projects, and we're again working for those as the must-dos and an execution. And then this year, we don't have very many innovations that are in flight. So this year, we're looking for initiating those. So if you think of something that's innovative, reach out to the architecture team, and they can make sure we get a demand in and we start that process and see where we need to get that. And the goal is that we get five of those started to meet that max. Lastly, we are starting to meet with our key business executives. Ro will have a little bit more about that in the project update, but our executive leaders are meeting with those key stakeholders to go over projects, and so you may see some summaries or you may be asked some questions to give feedback and status of those projects so that when we meet with those individuals, they can have accurate information. And I'll pass it back off.
Okay, so what I wanted to do here is really like, really just wanted us to like pause and just understand the amount of effort and work, and really want you guys to be very proud. I'm a data guy, so I love numbers, but you completed about 173 projects just this calendar year. You need to be very proud of that. That's a lot of effort. And if you think about the expansiveness of our organization and where we want to go and drive, and it's a tall order, and it's like something that I really want you to be proud of. If you look at that currently, not counting the ones you completed, there's 149 that are, and I actually put notes here, so if you guys are seeing all this right. So 149 projects that are there, and there's 155 in the backlog. These are the December implementations that are there. But again, going back to that, like, it's not just the number, it's also the importance of the work that you're doing. These are selected major project accomplishments, like Avasure, the bed planning, No Surprise Billing Act. They're phenomenal work, but those aren't the only ones. And now I'm going to look at my hand, and thank you, Carla Southwark, because she helped me write this through. The PEDS 5 North opening, that's something that you need to be very proud of. If you can imagine over a weekend to do this, and I remember clearly when Ben sent that text message saying about, like, this needs to go out. And I was sitting there, I'm like, holy crap, how are we going to be able to do it? But you guys pull that off. The other one is around automated results to K-High. You can imagine the impact that's going to happen, not only for the patients, but, like, you as family members, right? Like, when you're doing your immunizations or you're doing your test results, the fact that you could be in one place and receive that is actually pretty phenomenal. Other one is the opening of the PAV A fifth floor. That's actually pretty phenomenal work. You optimized workflow for five allied health areas. And don't forget about those 145 FSCM requests. if you think about that, you're like, oh, is it just an opening or closing of a floor? No, that's like an impact across the board. And you're able to do that as part of your work, as well as be successful in your IT goals are there. I want you to really like think about like the magnitude of the work that you're doing. You should be proud. And us as your leaders are very, very proud of that. So anyway, all of the stuff that I'm telling you, Carla was kind enough to help Angela and I and really point to like where you guys can do. So as I'm bragging to you, and if you ever feel like, whoa, you know, all I'm seeing is the tree and not the woods, and you want to take a step back and see what is the footprint of your work collectively, you can go there. You can go into ServiceNow and look at it. And the fact is that we ask a lot of you to do documentations, and I know it gets irritating and annoying. Thank you, Chris, for doing that. It's important because at the end of the day, it's a way for us to be not only to be to understand the workload that we're doing, to be able to take a step back and actually celebrate. So I really do want to thank you. I know stats can be a little bit boring, but God, those are a lot. So the other thing that you saw on the prior slide, and I didn't realize until I was giving a couple of people a call, which was like the IT executive partner. So for those folks who have been like ingrained into Epic, you know you've heard this concept of the BFF, right? Like best friends forever. So it's similar to that, right? You essentially, your IT leadership, we're basically buddied up with these folks in those specific areas. And the reason that we're doing that is what we realized is like what necessarily comes through ServiceNow and then from a lens may seem like a must do or should do, but sometimes you need a little bit of clarity, right? Like if you got like a gazillion must do's, what is really must do, right? And that helps us with that conversation. And the other thing is that we need to be able to understand what they're thinking before they actually start executing it. What is that ideation? What is it that's coming down the pike? So we can kind of better help and provide you insight and in some level protect you to do what's the right thing to do and what to focus on. And that's really our attempt to do that. So it may feel as if like we're going in and looking at what you're doing and that, it's really not the intent. The real intent is to be able to show the work that we're doing, how does that align with what they're expecting, and more importantly, what is coming up next. So I hope that clarifies it. If it doesn't, I'll email you Michael Rourke's cell phone number. He as long as you call before 9 p.m., I think we're okay. And to that dovetails really good into what Angela's going to talk about. Like, it's really about how other people see our work.
Great work throughout the year, and our work does matter. And here are two awards that the IT department has received this year, and it's in due to all of the efforts of everybody in this room, on the call, in our department, that we were able to meet most wired. We were at a level 8 for acute and for ambulatory. So we've done some great work there. I think level 10 is the highest you can get. And, you know, sometimes you don't necessarily want, we all want a gold medal and we all want that great, but sometimes it's, you know, where is the organization and where are our work efforts and our priorities at? And so we should be very proud of this level 8 because there were very few others. You know, it's think of all the hospitals across that fill out this and we were able to achieve this as well. Yeah, great job. As well as with Epic, we received Gold Star 9 this year, and we, there's probably some people that are like, well, we had 10 last year. Well, yes, we did, but we made a conscious decision not to go after that last element that would get us to the 10, and so we're very proud of our Gold Star 9. It places us in the top 16% of all health systems using that Epic application, and so we should be very proud of all the work that we've done and what we've been able to achieve, and you can see here what it actually measures and the top performers of those applications and the items that you all have done. So again, another round of applause for all those individuals engaged in this. And so we're not taking questions today because we're going to move right into the fun festivities. And Eddie's not in the room, but he did give me, he and his team, maybe I'll give a kudos to Grant, maybe Nick King's the other one, but I needed to print my stuff out, and I just had to walk over to radiology, scan my badge, and out it came. And I was like, oh, Merry Christmas, here it is. So I am received mine a little early, and we haven't figured out what we're going to get Misfit back here, but we'll get him off that island, so... We're going to get him away so Rudolph knows to get him find his way home because he had his directions on the back of his, on how to get here. So, but there'll be a survey coming out.
My wife is gone for the week, so I needed the directions.
So there'll be a survey coming out. Submit any questions. Those questions will go on the loop. I love the community page that we have on the loop to post those announcements so you can refer back to them. So we'll get those answers out there with all those questions. And no question too large, too small. We'll try to answer it. And if we can't answer it, we'll tell you. There's not anything to you know, you're not missing anything because there's nothing for us to be able to tell you. And with that, I think we have a cute video that's going to start. And then we have some special guests that'll be here with us.
Santa, try not to laugh challenge. Why shouldn't you lend money to elves? Because they're always short.
How did the ornament get addicted to Christmas? He was hooked on trees his whole life. Why did Santa send his daughter to college? To keep her off the North Pole. What do you call an elf that's doing hard time? A leprechaun. Get it? Con? Convict?
Got it?
Hey, why did the Grinch go to the liquor store? He was looking for some Christmas spirits.
Where does Santa store his suit? In my closet. What kind of music do elves listen to? Rap music?
How is Christmas exactly like your job? You do all the work, and some fat guy in suits gets all the credit.
Hey, whoa.
Did you hear that Santa
knows karate?
He's got a black belt. Hey! Yeah.
What does Santa use to clean his sleigh? Comet. Where do reindeer go if they lose a tail?
Where?
A retail store.
Hey, who hides in the bakery at Christmas? A mince pie. You know, like mince pie.
Mince pie.
Yep.
Good one. I left him.
Hey, what says O-O-O? Santa walking backwards.
I got one. Why did a booger cross the road? The booger.
Why?
Because she was picking on him.
Hey, what's Santa's nationality? He's North Polish. Why doesn't Santa go to the hospital? He has private elf care. What do you get if you cross Santa with a detective? Santa Claus.
What did one Christmas tree say to the other?
What?
I'm Philly.
Hi.
Why was the scarecrow featured in Business Monthly?
Why is that?
He was outstanding in his field.
Hey, Grinch, why do you enjoy gardening? What? You got a green thumb.
Happy holidays.
Silly fancy like Christmas. Round a fake tree. Nutcracker on a mantle and a candy cane. Can I get your eggnog with your fruitcake? Go Jesus, it's your birthday. Bougie like blow-ups in the front yard. Hope it's Santa gonna leave an Applebee's gift card in my sock. And even though we getting naughty all night, that's how we do it. how we do. Fancy like Christmas. Fancy like Christmas.
Happy holidays!
Santa!
Hey, how's it going?
Doing fine.
Glad you all could make it. I think we are ready to do some prizes here. But real quick, after we did that video, I heard some of these people out here don't believe in me.
I hear the same thing.
I'm through with all you rebels without a clause. All right, so we're going to do a little bit different this year on one thing. This is a Santa modification. So to encourage stealing, which makes the game more fun, right, Grinch?
Oh, yeah.
We are going, our friends over at Amazon, I don't know if you all know this, but the last 5 or 6 years, we've been using Amazon to help us deliver all the Christmas packages. So our friends over at Amazon have provided us a gift card. And so we selected a random number in the back. And so whoever steals, how many ever steals match that number, Grinch, we're going to need that. We'll get it later. Whoever steals the matches the random number we selected in the bag is going to get the gift card. So we got a number of steals to get to, and somebody's going to win the gift card. So are we ready to get started?
We
all right,
are.
We got helpers.
We'll have our elves come down, yes. And we got to get our numbers.
We got numbers. All right, you want me to select one, or you all got it? All right, our first number is, ends in 663,
707-663. Woohoo!
All right, come on down.
You just stick it in there.
Yeah. All right. So since you're first, you're going to get a chance to steal at the end potentially, but for now, you're just going to have to select one of the numbers and get the gift behind that number.
Three's over there.
Three.
It's the...
You ready? All right. Screaming goat. That'll come in handy in some of our conference calls.
And we'll ask you just to sit on the first or second row because don't get too attached. You might lose that.
My backyard.
My God.
That's awesome.
All right. So we're going to pick the next one. We are 636, 707-636.
Woo!
All right, Carla, come on. Hey, Grinch, she's kind of matching you over there.
Hey.
All right, so this is how this works now. You can steal the screaming goat. All right, right into it. All right, we have one steal. All right, so you have to select a number again. All right, what do we have?
Oh,
this is a good one. Santa likes this one. Wow. It is a calendar of dad jokes. Luckily, those aren't all Christmas jokes because those were pretty bad.
Is this where you got your
jokes from? No. Hopefully, those are better, actually. All right, so we're set, ready for the next one. All right, 707-662. All right, come on down.
Take the goat.
All right, how many steals are for each gift? Two?
Oh.
All right. Or three. Is the third time you get to keep it?
Yes.
Third time you keep it. All right, so you got a screaming goat, you got dad jokes, or you can select a gift behind one of the boxes.
Take the goat.
It's a screaming goat.
Just your regular screaming goat.
When you're frustrated, you can just have the goat scream. So.
Go with two.
Two. All right.
Okay.
All right. All right. Yeah, You got the car dealership. All right. I'm not sure. I think she would be okay if you stole that, just from the look on her face. All right, we got 707-692.
692.
697-692. 707-692?
What?
All right, we got Lindsay. Okay. Yeah, make sure your gifts are visible there. Don't be trying to steal, hide anything. All right, we got this. All right, the goat is now screaming in the front row here. All right, Lindsay's going with a number.
Yes, one.
All right. All right, you got some gel to clean your keyboard or your car. I think as much as we made you eat lunch in your car on the way to Lexington Clinic, you might need that.
Not edible.
Well, no. It'll clean up all the crumbs she left. Yeah. All right. 707-669.
Come on down.
Here we go. All right. So we're up to four gifts. You got the jail, the dad jokes, the screaming goat, the car dealership wavy dudes. It cleans your crumbs off your keyboard. Since we all eat work through lunch now, that'll
absorbs tears.
Oh, this is one of the favorites of the year. You have reindeer farts.
Are we sure they're reindeer or yours?
I can tell you that those are something else.
Also not
sitting edible. Behind the reindeer every year. What you got?
Those are edible.
Those are edible.
Those are edible farts.
All right. Here we go. So we got 707-693. All right. We got one coming from the back.
Why are all the winners over there? I think this is rigged.
Rigged.
This is rigged.
All right, we've only had one steal so far, so.
Go for the goat.
The Grinch may end up with a good card after all.
I'll take the goat.
Thank you.
All right. The goat is taking the second.
It's a gently used goat. Gently used goat.
Gently used goat. It's been used for the last 5 minutes. Yes.
He's from Eastern Kentucky. That was a good news back then.
You get. All right, reindeer farts are gone. So you can pick from here or steal again.
So let us know what you eat them.
All right, one. We're going with one. What do we have under box one? All right. Yeah, you got little tools, back scratchers, all the back scratchers. Yeah. So now when you're on a call, instead of wiggling your back and looking all silly, you can just scratch. Yeah.
Home use only.
Yeah.
Home use only.
All right. We're good?
Gently used.
The back scratches are gently used? 707-664.
664.
All right. Here we go. You got a steal.
Dad jokes.
Dad jokes.
The robbery.
All right, so you got a steal. You can steal.
I'll go
with
two.
Two. What are we up to? Three steals, Grant? Oh, this is a classic right here. This is a new one. Die Hard is my favorite Christmas movie, Mug.
Yes.
Yippee ki yay.
Santa has an advent calendar where he's falling down the towers of the Nakatani Tower.
Classic.
All right. Here we go. That one was sticking out too. 707-658.
658.
658. Here we go. All right. steal? Or
I think drawn to the cleaning because I like to clean.
All right. The cleaning gel has been stolen. I think that's the first steal. Luckily, that hasn't been gently used. All right, Die Hard Christmas Mug. That's what, the fifth steal? Are we up to four steals?
All right. I'm going to go with three.
This is a classic. This is a classic.
It's the hot dog.
Oh, maker. It is.
If you all remember, Santa almost had that, and the red-headed Grinch Jason stole it from him.
Take it and run.
I'm good. I'm good.
You're good? You've been good this year?
I wasn't red.
You didn't do it?
Wasn't
been
me.
Good this year? I've noticed
that. No, I'm never good.
Let's see. 707-668.
668. What?
All right. We got Michael. Stealing. Take a good look. Make them all nervous. Stand over them a little bit.
That's a nice one. What you got
there? The cleaning gel.
You trying to get that away? I gotta go for the cup.
Cup has gone twice. Is that the fifth steal? Fifth steal, Grinch? All right.
That'd be five.
Okay. Lindsay, you get to steal. All right, that was the sixth steal and the winner of the Amazon gift card.
Michael, are you going to sign the dad joke since you wrote it?
All right. Do we got dad jokes? Are we going to steal or hot dogs? All right. This is getting active.
Okay. Let's go back to one.
All right. Back to one.
This is nice.
It's a shoulder warmer. Yeah.
It looks classy, too.
None of us. All right, that was a new one, so we're ready to get another person up here.
Oh, yes, you're right.
All right. 707-671.
671.
We have two people that lost their
tickets,
so it might be one.
Uh-oh. Well, then they lose out. Yeah, if you can't keep a ticket for 10 feet, we're going to move on.
That is harsh.
You wouldn't keep your gift until you got out the door.
707-635. 635.
All right, Darren. All right, we got a couple things that are getting close to final steal here.
Well, I got to steal the hot dog thing.
All right. Where are we at on that? Was that the second or third steal?
Second.
All right. You're about to choose. You can choose or you can steal. Oh, it's another classic. The yodeling pickle.
Oh.
Reminds
you can
me of
send
it
to the steaming goat. It makes great music.
Michael wants that.
Okay, all right. So that was a new one. We're ready. 707-649.
649.
649.
649.
Is that the other one that lost their ticket? Whoever's cleaning the auditorium, let me know where you found those. 707-696.
696.
All right, Charlie. I feel like the competition's getting ready to get intense.
I think it's
great. That screaming goat was selling good on an airplane, Charlie, this afternoon. So with the yodeling pickle. All right, we got the yodeling pickle, screaming goat, back scratchers, dad jokes. All right, dad jokes. Where are we at on those?
Surprisingly very popular.
That's three on the dad jokes? All right, Charlie, you are
the
stuck with the dad jokes. Or you win the dad jokes. Depends on how you do it. All right. All right.
You got
a steal. Yeah.
Got another steal.
Or you can. We still have gifts. Find boxes. is a good one. All right, we got a footrest. Very handy.
Gently used.
Yeah, Rose only used that for a week, so you're good.
It's meant to be rough.
All right. 707-648. 648. Anyone? I think some people are scared to actually come up here now.
Million dollar check.
All right. 707-661.
Oh my God.
Say, oh.
All right, we got one.
Tell you, it's rigged.
We're getting to the point, we've still got a few gifts left, but there's a lot out there. Lots to choose from. The dad jokes are, everything in the front row is still eligible for steal.
Gourmet hot dog.
I just want to show her what you got.
Yeah, we got a hot dog maker, we got mug, cleaner, yodeling pickle, screaming goat, back scratcher, footrest, shoulder warmer. All right. The yodeling pickle is out. Now that's first one on yodeling pickle.
Make a choice.
Hot dog maker.
It's done, right? It's
that's
done.
That's the hot dog maker stopped, right?
It is.
The enterprise architect couldn't have ended up with that 2 years in a row.
It's a.
All right.
Door number one.
Similar. You got food anyway. We got a s'mores maker. All right, door number one is closed. All right, we're getting down to the end. It looks like three gifts left.
See, so, we could do a potluck with this stuff.
Yeah, we can. Bring those to the next picnic. Bring the hot dog maker
and the s'mores maker. S'mores makers.
707-691.
691.
All right, Grant.
Only 10 years.
This is the first one ever.
Make it a good one. You got plenty to choose from. Hot dog maker and dad jokes are out and everything else.
Keyboard
cleaner. All right.
Well, I'm sorry. It was the dad jokes, but then you took it in and outside.
All right. All right. You can steal or. Well, you just lost your cleaner too, so that didn't. Number three. Yeah, this is a good choice. I think you're gonna. The question is, can you hang on to it? Are you gonna be able to hang on to it?
Oh, it's
the leg lamp. Yeah, be careful with that. It's very fragile.
Really suggest you do not leave that in the office.
Yeah. All right. 707-656.
6656.
656. All right. Doors one and three are closed now, so we only have one present open. Everything's available. Show what you got.
That's not.
He's a keyboard cleaner because you've been cleaning up crap.
Oh, we had a request for the fruit cake. All right, number two. What do we have for number two? I actually don't know what this one is. Oh, it's the game, the bar toss game. Grinch and I play that for hours.
Shows.
All right. 707-697.
697.
There's one gift left too, by the way, just so you know. No one's claiming 697? 707-666. All right.
Somebody's naughty.
Yeah, somebody's very naughty. Grinch, did you put that ticket in there?
Just for her.
I knew it.
All right, so the shoulder warmer got stolen. There's one gift left. You got steals. Steal. Oh, I think the mug is out. All right, so we now.
It was her favorite.
So the hot dog maker, the dad jokes, and the mug are done. Everything else is available, Michael. Anything you want.
Steal.
Keep going.
Go for two.
All right. You have the Hanukkah gift set. All right. So, number one, you get the choice to steal.
Are we swapping?
Yeah.
But she then can.
Well, Jilly.
Yeah, she can swap. She can swap. You want to steal or are you good with the footrest? All right, the s'mores maker.
Well, I want Marcus game then.
All right, the bar game.
It's getting ruthless
right,
now.
This is getting tough.
Yes, we got to cut the recording.
It's going to be hard to keep track of all the numbers. All right, our footrest or somebody else's?
That's dead.
The back scratcher. bro, no one wants your used footrest. All right. You can trade that, or if you're happy with Rose's footrest.
Hey, it was quality control inspected, so it works pretty awesome.
Wait, yeah, okay.
Meant to be crusty.
I think the putty's out. The putty's out. The lamp's still alive. All right. One more. Back to the footrest. Here we go.
Hold it up if it's still available.
All right, if you're still available. All right, we got the pickle, the car thing, the mug is gone, the reindeer farts, the
game,
the goat, the screaming goat, the. All right, the game's
Smart
coming
hat.
Back. Footrest is a problem here. All right, damn. S'mores maker back. Where are we going? S'mores maker back. All right. Is the s'mores maker out now? Or it's out. Okay. All right. You can go. You're still in. We can keep going until everything hits three. Leg lamp. All right. Leg lamp's out.
I'm trying to get offended, Santa. I'm sorry.
I don't think. You may need to go for a pedicure this afternoon, Rose. All right. You can keep the footrest or you can keep going. It's up to you. Uh-oh. Here we go. We're looking. Hold it up if it's still available. All right. We got a yodeling pickle. We got the auto wavy thing, the back scratcher, the Hanukkah. All right, the back scratcher. It's done. The back scratchers are done.
Is the back thing still warmer? Is that been three or is that available?
It's out. All right. Let's see. What are we still looking at?
The game. Is the cleaning clip or is that?
It's gone.
Then I'll take the goat.
All right, the goat's done.
I'm short. I'll shut it down.
All right. The footrest is there. Well. Okay, I think think that was a record number of steals. Good job, everyone. Good job.
Well, thank you all for coming. I believe in the hallways we've got some snacks.
Yes, down this hallway here, there's a table with some snacks if you're in the room. And then there's some music in the lobby if you want to go out there and listen to that.
You can use your footrest if need be.
Before you go, let's thank the group.